My name's Nick Bradshaw. I'm the web editor at Sight & Sound magazine. It's a very great honor to welcome back to the stage the documentary master, Patricio Guzman. We've got half an hour, so I'll ask a few questions and then open it up to the audience. And we're filming as well, so there will be a microphone to pass around to. So please wait for that for asking your questions. Thank you. Patricio, I think I speak for many when I say I'm very glad that you, for your adult career, that you took up the film camera rather than the telescope. I wonder if making this film gave you cause to consider a lot of what ifs and alternate realities.
Te hizo preguntar si hubieras buscado otras realidades también.
No entiendo. Well, I'm talking about yourself, but I mean in terms of Chile as well.
En términos de Chile, other realities.
You talk about having wanted to be an astronomer when in your childhood.
You were
stargazing.
Y si ahora estás contento de haber elegido ser cineasta, esa
persona. No se puede ser astrónomo
si no. You can't be an astrologer.
Si no se saben matemáticas.
If you don't know maths.
Y yo no sé nada de matemáticas.
And I'm not really good at maths. It's a problem.
No se puede saltar la matemática.
You can't avoid it. You can't jump over it.
Mi ayudante de dirección.
My assistant director.
Quería transformarse en astrónomo después de hacer la película.
Got so enthusiastic he wanted to become an astronomer.
Y el astrónomo de la película, Gaspar.
And Gaspar, the astronomer that's interviewed.
Le metió en la universidad.
Actually got him into university.
En la facultad de astronomía.
In the astronomy department.
Pero le dijo lo mismo. Si no sabes, si no puedes saltar, si no puedes aprender el álgebra.
But he said if you don't learn your algebra,
no vas a hacer, a poder hacer nada.
You won't get very far.
Duró un año.
He lasted 1 year.
Had to know some maths to be a filmmaker as well.
No necesitas matemáticas para ser cineasta.
No, porque los documentalistas no somos hombres de ciencia.
As a documentarist, I'm not sure about it. You don't need to be a mathematician.
No, no somos hombres de ciencia.
And we're not scientists.
Somos artistas.
We're artists.
Se puede hacer una película sobre pintura sin saber pintura.
You can make a film about painting without knowing about it.
Se puede hacer una película de Picasso sin conocer a Picasso.
Without knowing Picasso.
Se puede hacer una aproximación libre sobre Picasso.
You can make a sort of approximate, a free interpretation.
Y puede ser un gran documental.
And it could even be a great documentary.
Pero no somos hombres de ciencia.
But we're not scientists.
Somos subjetivos.
We're subjective.
Somos apasionados.
I'm passionate.
No somos hombres de ciencia.
We are not scientists.
So when you first approached your colleagues and partners who know you as a political filmmaker, perhaps foremost.
Colleagues, cuando fuiste a hablar con los colegas sobre
With this idea of a film about the stars and the deserts, did they think you'd gone mad? Was it easy to explain?
Los que pensaron eso fueron los
the ones who thought that
los canales de televisión
were the TV channels.
Porque nos rechazaron 16 canales.
16 different channels rejected the idea.
Todos los franceses.
All the French ones.
Arte.
Arte.
France 2. France 3, Odyssey, Planet, Canal Plus, Ushuaia, todos dijeron no, no,
all of them said no, no, no.
17 nos.
17 nos, no's.
4 canales holandeses.
4 Dutch channels.
2 finlandeses.
2 Finnish ones.
1 americano.
1 American one.
No entendieron nada.
They could not understand it at all.
No se arriesgan.
They could not take the risk.
No toman riesgos.
They don't dare to take the risks.
Cualquier tema distinto les parece peligroso.
They think it's too dangerous.
Y así no se llega a ninguna parte.
And of course, then that way you never get anywhere.
Ese es el problema.
That's the problem.
El documental de autor sigue
con. The author documentary.
Sigue con muchos problemas.
Always will have problems.
Solamente entra en National Geographic.
Only the National Geographic.
Documentary channel.
Documentary channels.
Animalitos.
With little animals.
Pero no ideas.
But no ideas.
Are you saying it's always been that way? This is not. Things aren't getting worse.
O las cosas se ponen peores.
Hemos pasado por momentos buenos.
We have had good moments.
No muchos.
Not very many.
Nos hemos acostumbrado a vivir en crisis.
We have got accustomed to living in crisis.
Que empezó mucho antes que la crisis económica de ahora.
Of course, it started a long time before this credit crunch now.
Es difícil hacer documentales de autor.
It is difficult to make an auteur documentary.
No ganamos mucho dinero.
We don't make much money.
Y no se nos hace confianza.
And nobody trusts us.
Porque, por ejemplo, podían haber dudado del guión.
They could have doubted my script.
Pero yo ya soy viejo, he hecho otros documentales.
But on the other hand, I've made a lot of documentaries. I'm not so young anymore.
Y dijeron que no.
But they still said no.
O sea, uno sigue como si tuviese 18 años.
So you continue as if you were still 18. And
me
just
gusta
starting.
Mucho porque me hace sentirme joven.
Of course, I feel younger as a result.
And is this sort of amazingly ambitious film with these kind of layers and fractals and different metaphors. And did you, when you first seized the idea, did you have to, was there a lot of working it out yourself, or could you see the connections immediately?
A mí me gusta mucho la escritura documental.
I like to write a script for the documentary.
Que yo llamo documental guión imaginario.
My imaginary script.
Imagino la película.
I imagine my film.
Y comienzo a hacer deducciones.
And I start to make deductions.
Y estuve 5 años en eso.
I was 5 years working on it.
Y como nadie aprobaba la idea.
And as nobody, and as everyone rejected the idea.
Mi mujer se transformó en productora.
My wife became the producer.
Y así pudimos hacer la
and vida. Therefore we were able to make it eventually.
Yo imaginé muchas cosas en mi casa.
I imagined a lot of the things in my own home.
Que resultaron ser muy exactas.
That turned out to be dead on.
Y otras que cambiaron por completo.
And a lot of others that were completely different.
Por ejemplo, la secuencia de los asteroides.
For instance, the whole sequence of the asteroids.
Comparado con los huesos humanos.
Comparing it with human bone.
Se me ocurrió en mi casa.
I actually thought of it at home.
Y cuando llegamos a Chile, filmamos
and
pequeños huesos.
When we got to Chile, we filmed the little pieces of bones.
Y pusimos fotos de asteroides.
And we combined it with the asteroid photographs.
Y salió muy bien.
And it came out okay.
Lo estupendo es que en un observatorio.
The terrific thing is that in one observatory.
Encontramos a un viejo astrónomo.
We found an old astronomer.
Norteamericano.
An American.
Que estaba mirando una constelación porque tenía calcio.
Who was at that time observing a constellation that had calcium.
Que era exactamente lo que nosotros decíamos.
Which was exactly what we had thought of and
que un cuerpo
coincided.
Y un trozo de hueso son lo mismo.
That a piece of star and a piece of bone end up being the same thing.
Porque la materia es la misma en todo.
Because matter is the same everywhere.
Pero en otras ideas, todo cambió porque
a lot of other ideas
porque lo mostramos a la gente.
depending on what we found.
Hacer un documental siempre es una aventura.
To make a documentary is always an adventure.
Es como un viaje.
It's a journey.
No se sabe dónde uno va a parar.
You never know where you're going to go and where you're going to end.
Y eso es lo más bonito.
And that's the best of all.
Es, no es seguro.
There's no security, there's no sureness, you never know.
Y es artesanal.
And it's got that craft feeling about it.
Y eso me gusta mucho.
And that's what I like.
Es como hacer automóviles de madera.
It's like making a car out of wood.
Y es un riesgo permanente.
And of course, it's a permanent risk.
Y hay que hacer mucha improvisación.
And you have to learn to improvise.
Por eso es que los canales desconfían.
That's why the TV channels are scared.
Ellos van a la segura.
They want something safe.
Pero ningún arte va a la segura.
But art will never be safe.
La televisión se ha alejado de nosotros.
So TV has become too far, has gone too far away from us.
Pero no importa.
But it doesn't really matter.
Can you tell us a bit about the kind of filming the stars and using working with special effects, which I think must be quite new for you? Did you enjoy that kind of adventure?
Sí, los polvitos. You mean the dust, stardust?
En un observatorio.
In one of the observatories that we visited.
No había telescopio.
There was the whole dome had no telescope within.
Y utilizaban esa cúpula para
they had the cupola,
para guardar basura.
Where they just kept rubbish, really.
O viejos equipos.
And old equipment.
Y a mí me gustó mucho porque
and I liked it.
Esa era la imagen del golpe de estado.
Because it was like the image of the coup d'état.
Era la destrucción.
The destruction.
Y en el suelo había una capa de polvo.
And there was a huge layer of dust on the ground.
Y entonces mi ayudante y yo
and with my assistant,
tomamos el polvo,
we would grab it
y lo tiramos
and we threw it into the air.
Y como había una luz de catedral,
and as it was a ray of light like from a cathedral,
lo que apareció fue la Vía Láctea.
What appeared was the Milky Way.
Es un recurso muy barato.
It was a very it was a very cheap special effects.
And how's the film been received in Chile now? Is there and is there a healthier climate of cinema dealing with its amnesia about the coup years, the dictatorship years?
La película se dio en 8 salas.
The film has been shown in 8 different venues.
Hizo 6,000 espectadores.
And it managed to achieve 6,000. Spectators, viewers.
Pero en Francia ha hecho 70,000.
On the other hand, in France there were 70,000.
En Francia lleva un año.
In France it has been screened for 1 year.
Y 4 meses.
And 4 months.
Y en Chile duró.
And in Chile
un mes.
It lasted 1 month.
No me acuerdo.
Can't remember exactly.
Y en Estados Unidos se ha dado más de 100 salas.
On the other hand, in the States, it's been shown in 100 different venues.
Y tenemos copias en Bélgica, Alemania.
And there are copies in Belgium, Germany,
y Suiza.
And Switzerland.
Y aquí, y ahora.
And here now.
Y en Chile es difícil
it's difficult
proyectar documentales.
To project documentaries.
Porque no hay distribuidores.
There are no distributors.
Las escuelas de cine,
the cinemas, the schools of cinema,
film schools, enseñan dirección,
will teach directing,
montaje,
or editing,
fotografía,
cinematography,
pero no enseñan a distribuir.
But they will not teach you how to distribute a film.
Es increíble.
It's incredible.
¿Por qué no se enseña a distribuir?
Why they don't? It's a mystery.
Porque tenemos una gran falta de distribuidores independientes
there's
del mundo.
A vast lack of distributors in the whole world.
Y es una excelente profesión.
And it is an excellent profession.
Apasionante.
Very deep.
Pero no hay.
But there's a lack of it.
Y en América Latina no tenemos.
And in Latin America there are none.
Solo distribuyen cine norteamericano.
They only distribute American films.
Reciben todo.
all.
La copia.
They get everything directly in their hands. The copies, the prints.
Subtitulada.
And it's all subtitled.
El press book.
They've got all the press information.
El trailer.
The trailers.
Todo.
Everything.
Ellos tienen
package.
Que tomar todo eso y llevarlo a la sala.
All they need to do is get it and they've got it up, the whole thing.
No hacen nada.
They don't need to do a thing.
Pero si llega una película iraní, no saben qué hacer.
But if an Iranian film arrives, they're stuck. They don't know what to do.
Chilena tampoco.
And that, or a Chilean one, it's the same stuff.
Ese es el problema.
That's the problem.
Si tuviéramos distribuidores buenos, se llenaría.
If we had good distributors, it would be a different story.
Just one more question. I want to go back to the astronomy as a metaphor, but I think you've lived over half your life in exile now. Do you ever feel like you're studying Chile and its past through a telescope?
Como has vivido mucho tiempo en el exilio, si a veces te sentís que estás observando a tu propio Chile por medio de un telescopio.
No. Yo creo que una de las cosas interesantes
en
el documental es que hay que guardar la distancia.
Is that you need the objectivity, the distance.
No es para ser objetivo.
No.
No. Hay que tener distancia para guardar las proporciones.
A distance in order to keep the proportions.
Para tener perspectiva.
To keep your perspective.
No para ser objetivo.
Not to be objective.
Todo lo contrario.
On the contrary.
Pero hay que tener esa distancia.
You need that distance.
Y yo viviendo fuera de Chile me doy cuenta mejor de lo que pasa en Chile que muchos colegas que viven
aquí. And living outside of Chile, I'm able to see more clearly what's happening than the people who are living within.
Es la ventaja del exilio.
And that, I suppose, is an advantage of the exile.
Y a mí no me importa vivir fuera de Chile.
And I don't mind living outside
of
Chile.
No soy nostálgico.
I'm not I don't feel nostalgic.
No me gustan las empanadas.
I don't like the pasties in Chile.
No me gusta la música chilena tampoco.
I don't like Chilean music particularly either.
Me gusta el vino tinto.
But I like the good wine.
Aparte de eso, no tengo ningún problema en vivir fuera.
And apart from that, I have no problem living abroad.
No importa donde uno viva.
It doesn't matter where you live.
Porque uno tiene una mochila.
Because you have a rucksack.
Donde están la primera comunión.
Where you have your first communion.
El primer amor.
Your first love.
La casa donde uno nació.
The house where you were born.
El barrio.
Your little neighborhood.
El primer colegio.
The first school.
Y eso nunca sale de aquí.
And that never leaves your rucksack.
Da lo mismo donde uno vive.
Doesn't matter where you are.
Porque eso siempre va a estar contigo.
You will always be carrying it with you.
Anyone in the audience have any questions for Patricio? Hands up, there's a hand here, I can see. I'll have to look further back.
Hello, first of all, I'm a university student here in London, and it was a great film. Thank you very much. And what interested me is that you talked about a film director being like an artist. You journey around, it requires a lot of effort, and there's always a sense of crisis lingering behind in the background. And so, like, my question is, as a film director, especially in this documentary, any artist would have the intention, did you more feel closely to a political activist or a metaphysicist?
No soy activista político.
I'm not a political activist.
Y no soy metafísico.
And I'm not a metaphysicist.
No, yo pienso que el documentalista es una mirada sobre la
realidad. I think the documentary filmmaker gives a look, gives a point of view.
Es más sencillo.
It's simpler than that.
Lo que hay que aprender a mirar es,
you have to learn to look,
es que la vida está llena de átomos.
Is that the life is full of atoms.
Átomos dramáticos.
Dramatic at.
Por ejemplo, uno sale a la calle.
For instance, you go into the street.
Y hay un hombre que está mirando al suelo.
And there's a man gazing at the road.
No se sabe por qué.
You don't know why.
Ese es un átomo dramático.
That's a dramatic atom.
Tiene un desarrollo dramático mínimo.
It has a minimal development of drama.
Pero tiene.
But it's there.
Y más allá hay un
and over there there's another man
que está tratando de abrir un coche
who's trying to open a
car
door
con un alambre
with a piece of wire
porque se le quedó la llave
because he forgot his key.
Ahí hay otro átomo.
There's another dramatic atom.
Y los átomos son
and
como
atoms,
son como letras.
They're like letters.
Y con esas letras se hacen
and
palabras.
With those letters you gradually create a word.
Y con esas palabras se hacen frases.
And with those words you make a sentence.
Eso es todo.
And that's what it is really. That's all.
Okay. Thank you very much.
No, thank you.
Good question. In the other back on the other side. Oh, we've got two mouths.
Okay, I have a question about audiences. You talked about the fact that you know, there are all these problems about distributing a film. But at the same time, it seems that you have much wider audiences abroad. So my question is, what does it mean to you to share these images and to share this past with an international audience?
¿Qué significa para ti comunicar estas ideas a tu público? En el exterior.
Bueno, ninguna película mía ha sido comprada por la televisión chilena.
None of my films have been bought by Chilean TV.
No solamente las mías.
Not only mine.
Sino de otros colegas jóvenes.
Of other young filmmakers as well.
Que han hecho películas sobre la memoria.
That have also dealt with memory.
Porque la televisión chilena es completamente mercantil.
Because it's completely commercial.
El Estado da una subvención.
The state does give a slight subsidy
para hacer documentales.
For documentaries.
Y la televisión que es del Estado no las pasa.
But the television that is also state doesn't show them.
Es una contradicción.
It's a contradiction.
Y para mí es importante tener un público.
And of course, it's very important for me to have a public.
Porque uno siente.
Because you feel.
Las reacciones.
You can feel the reactions.
Cuando se pasa por televisión una película.
When you show something on TV.
Y a uno le dicen, la han visto 100,000 personas.
And somebody says to you, 100,000 people have seen this.
Uno no siente nada.
But you feel nothing.
En cambio, en una función de cine.
But when you're in the actual screening.
Uno aprende del público.
You learn from your own public or your own audience.
Y con las preguntas de ustedes yo aprendo.
And with every question you make, I learn.
Esa es la gran diferencia de cuando pasa por televisión y cuando hay
un That's the difference from an audience and a TV.
No sé si respondí bien.
I don't know if that was what you wanted me to say.
What do you think you gain, especially from an international audience? What do you think you learn from them as opposed to a national public?
Yo no hago la competencia entre el público chileno.
I don't do this competition between Chilean or international audience.
No. Si tuviéramos los medios económicos,
if we had the economical means,
la película
financial means,
podría tener un gran éxito en Chile.
Perhaps the film could have success in Chile.
Pero teníamos 8 copias y ningún dinero para hacer publicidad.
And no money to make any publicity at all.
Para mí no hay ninguna diferencia que se vea aquí o se vea allá.
And so in a way there is no difference for me whether it's seen here or there. It's the same.
El público árabe.
The Arab audiences.
El público norteamericano.
Or American audiences.
O el mexicano reaccionan igual.
Or the Mexican audiences. In the end, it's not that different.
How about the fact that if you're showing to an international audience, okay, there may be Chilean exiles within your audience, but largely your international audience would be composed by people who have not had a direct experience or been witnesses to the history that you're testifying to in your films. So your films are also a chance for them to engage with that history through the images, the very powerful images that you produce.
Es muy satisfactorio para uno.
There is satisfaction in that.
Cuando uno consigue acercarse a un lenguaje universal.
When you manage to touch on something universal.
Y eso es una cosa que se produce de repente.
And that's something that can happen unexpectedly.
No se puede planificar.
You can't plan for it.
Yo sé que llego a un que yo tengo un lenguaje universal.
I know that some of it have a universal language.
Pero no sé por qué.
But I don't know why.
No, es como la poesía.
It's like poetry.
O la emoción.
Or even emotions.
No hay ningún aparato capaz de medir la emoción.
You can't. There is no apparatus that can measure emotion.
Se puede medir el sonido.
You can measure sound.
El montaje.
In the editing.
Pero no la emoción.
But not the emotional reaction.
Y llegar a un público universal.
And to reach an audience on a universal level.
No sé cuál es la receta.
I don't know what the recipe is.
No sé qué otra cosa decir.
Thank you very much.
Question over there on the left.
Okay, well, I can't scream.
No,
Well, thank you very much. I think you've managed to provoke, I'm not going to speak on behalf of everybody, but just certainly for me, you provoked a very special nostalgia or a very special feeling, which took me to kind of maybe a little bit of my own personal relationship to this universe and also to my life. And I suppose that's very, very, very powerful. It was very powerful for me because I was thinking and I was looking and I was reflecting. But my question from a filmmaking point of view, how did you manage to construct the script, which I don't think you wrote at the beginning, but it rather came while you were making the film. But how did you decide to draw the relationship between up there and down there and inside here and your heart?
And what else?
And his personal experience with the Chilean, of course. Which in a way I think it's make both local audience in Chile who would have also personal relationship and also global audience like myself who...
La primera idea fue
the first idea
hacer una película
was to make a film
para demostrar que el pasado es importante.
To show that the past is important.
Para mí, el pasado es todo en la vida.
For me, the past is everything in your life.
Incluso creo que el futuro viene del pasado.
Even the future comes from the past.
Y no me refiero al pasado de mi cuerpo.
And I don't mean my own physical past.
De mis padres, de mis
abuelos. But my own parents, my grandparents.
También me refiero al pasado de la materia.
And even the past of matter.
Y el pasado del cosmos.
And the cosmos itself.
Es lo mismo.
It all becomes the same thing.
Solo vivimos en el pasado.
We live only in the past.
Y este era la primera motivación.
That was the first starting point of motivation.
La segunda fue encontrar el lugar.
The second one was to find a location.
Que era el desierto.
Which was the desert.
Que es un territorio del pasado.
Which is a territory that belongs to the past.
Todo está ahí.
Everything is there.
Las metáforas son del desierto, no son mías.
The metaphors come from the desert, not mine.
Porque todo está ahí.
It's all there.
Hay animales fósiles.
There are fossils.
Hay meteoritos.
There are meteorites.
Hay restos humanos.
And human remains.
Están los observatorios.
There are the observatories.
Arqueólogos.
And the archaeologists.
Momias.
And the mummies.
Es todo un territorio del pasado.
It's a territory that belongs to the past.
Por lo tanto, se puede comparar a la momia con una galaxia.
So you can compare, in a sense, a mummy with a piece of the galaxy.
Y poco a poco uno entra en un terreno.
And gradually you get into a
territory
of reflection.
y de juxtaponer
and juxtaposition
cosas que no se suelen
things that don't normally come together.
Y poco a poco se va construyendo un
and gradually you construct
un discurso que se transforma en una reflexión
that
filosófica.
Becomes a philosophical reflection.
No se puede explicar más que eso.
It's difficult to explain it any other way.
Otra cosa interesante.
Another thing that's interesting.
La historia de los astrónomos es como una columna.
The history of the astronomers is like a column.
Los arqueólogos también.
The archaeologists as well.
Las mujeres que buscan también.
And the women who are searching also.
No se tocan.
They don't normally touch.
Un astrónomo nunca habla con un arqueólogo.
The archaeologist doesn't normally have a conversation with an astronomer.
Y lo interesante era cruzar las historias.
The interesting thing was to link them, to cross them.
Y cuando se cruzaron, apareció una historia cinematográfica.
That's when the narrative and the story emerges.
Y en parte porque yo había escrito un guión.
In part because I had written a script.
Y en parte por la casualidad.
And partly because of things that just happened.
Y por supuesto el guión que yo hago, el que yo
obviously,
llamo,
the,
que yo
script
llamo,
that I write, my imaginary script,
nunca lo llevo a la filmación.
I never take it with me.
Se queda en el hotel.
It stays in the hotel.
Porque no sirve para nada.
Because actually it's not used at all.
Delante de la realidad.
When you're faced with reality.
Es un elemento para organizar en la cabeza.
It's an element for me to organize my own mind.
Pero no sirve para nada.
But in fact it's not useful.
Es un elemento más.
It's an element, another
pero
es, ingredient.
Pero yo recomiendo a mis alumnos que escriban.
But I still recommend my students to write.
Porque, bueno, escribir es útil.
Because it's useful in the end.
Pero hay colegas que no escriben nada.
But of course there are many colleagues that refuse to
pero
write
yo,
anything.
Que yo admiro mucho.
And yet I admire their work very much.
Nicolás Philibert, el francés, no escribe nada.
Nicolas
Philibert
never writes a thing.
Wiseman no escribe nada.
Wiseman either.
Él se ríe cuando yo le digo que hago guiones imaginarios.
Even when and he laughs if I tell him to make his imaginary script.
Y tiene razón.
And perhaps he's right.
I'm afraid we have to cut it off there. Terribly sorry for those of you still with questions, but we have run out of time. So I'd like to thank Patricio, very, very much for presenting this film. And, thank you to Salvador and DocHouse for bringing it tonight, and I hope you'll tell all your friends about the film because it's out on release very soon. Thank you very much.